Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to be having a look at what is in this brown box. This is part of the Ubiquiti Air Max range. This is the Rocket Prism 5AC, so the RP-5AC. We'll go through the items you get in the box. Not meant to be a technical overview, but we'll give you a little bit of insight as we go along. This is the actual core part of the transmitter itself, which we'll have a look at in a moment. Now remember, with the Ubiquiti Air Max range, pretty much all of them, there are a couple of exceptions, are powered by 24-volt PoE. So you're going to get a 24-volt PoE pack injector there in the box. So I just hold that up to you. You're obviously going to get your PoE out that's going to run out down your cable, up your pole or whatever, to the device. And you're going to get your LAN in. It's going to connect there to your router. On this side here, you are going to get, obviously, where you're going to make your mains power in. In the box, you're going to get a short, it's probably about just over a meter long power cable. This is Australian, so you're going to get our Australian power connector on that end. And then you're going to get your cloverleaf or Mickey Mouse, depending on however you like to look at that connector on that end. You are going to get a tiny little get started conformance guide that you probably won't open in from the packaging. And if I can unmagnetize this from the desk that I'm working on, you are going to get your GPS locator and its connector there at that end, which will connect directly into the unit itself. So this is part, like I said, of the Air Max range. You need to connect this to an antenna. There are a number of antenna options from Omni right the way through to sector antennas. This is probably designed perfectly for what's called the Rocket Prism sector antenna, which is a 90 degree antenna, and you mount three of these into it. Each one takes a 30 degree segment. This is designed for high end user connectivity. So we've got one of these set up in a central location, and it's then connecting out to a number of buildings all around that sector. Do watch our other video. We've done a video on what do I need to run point to point. The card will appear in the video that we're doing here, and that will give you a little bit more of an idea of point to point and point to multipoint. But this is one of the devices you use. This is the transmitter. This is the bit that actually makes the signal work, and this pushes it up then to whichever antenna is appropriate for your situation. So there we go. We're going to get three connectors on the end. I think they're called SCA connectors. Well, let me take that off so you can have a little look. All right, the front. On the front here, we have a number of indicators from power to signal strength, just to give you an idea how that is lined up. Those are your indicator for how well it's lined up. Obviously, with your GPS connector here connected to one of these, that is going to give you a better exact signal, which is going to help you line both of these up. Obviously, these are going to work in, well, not necessarily they're going to work in a pair. You could run these in a pair, but you're going to have this at one location. Maybe you've got an LAP 90 at one location, or a nano beam or a power beam. You can get, obviously, your exact GPS location off this, which will help you doing the lineup, especially if you're at 5 or 10 kilometers. It's going to be a little bit difficult to see. So at the back here, hopefully you can see that you are going to get some connections there to, if you needed to, mount this section directly onto a pole. Like I said, this is designed to fit in to a surrounding already, so you don't get any extra rack mount fits or anything. Those are going to come with the antenna that you purchase. That will then fit on the top, and then the rocket will actually clip into place here. But like I said, you can see here this, the grips on here to mount it onto the pole. All right, then on the bottom here, if we just push this down securely and out and lift that up, you're going to see you've got a single Ethernet connection in. And just above that there, you've got your reset switch or reset button. All right, so you're going to cable up. Now, I do recommend every time you do this, you make sure you have a drip loop. I'm sure you've thought of that. But we do have a tendency, we've got an antenna on here, and we've maybe come up a pole, and we're just going to put the cable straight up inside here. That's okay. In the worst case, we maybe just come straight down and straight inside. Can I always recommend that if you're coming up the pole or even down the pole, all right, that we come up to a height that's above the unit. We then come out, we come down, all right, and we come up in. So essentially, we've got a drip loop of cable here. What does that mean? Any moisture that builds up in here, all right? Because this is the worst thing. Any moisture that builds up in here, it runs down the case, runs onto the cable, and drips off. If we just have our cable going straight down or maybe even straight out, there is a tendency that now moisture will now be able to run down the cable. And if there is a chance that it's got inside the cable, it now travel inside the cable. So if we've come up our pole, make sure that we go in, down, loop up. It means anything, any condensation on here or on your cable will come to the bottom of the loop and then drip off. This will give you a connectivity speed of up to about 500 megasecond. Fantastic, good for multi-point to point. Or if you wanted to do some high power point to point, it could be there a useful option for you. But like I said, do check out a whole load more of our YouTube videos. We've got a great one there on what is point to point or what do I need to run point to point. Do head on over, subscribe. We've got box openings on firewalls, networking, and wireless device. Plenty of how-to guides, so it's worth staying up to date on the reviews that we've got going, but hopefully that's been useful. That's the Rocket Prism, the Ubiquiti Air Max Rocket Prism RP-5AC.